Hi, I'm Alex with Splunk Education. Do you ever find yourself learning a new command and wish you had pretend data to work with? The makeresults command can help make that dream a reality. By default, the makeresults command generates one search result in temporary memory that is not saved to disk or indexed. However, there are a variety of optional arguments that allow tons of flexibility in creating diverse results to work with. MakeResults is a generating command, so it'll be the first command in the search, only preceded by a pipe. To return a single result, we will run the search as is. If we'd like to see more than one result, we can add count is equal to and the integer representing the number of results we want. The annotate argument generates values for the underscore raw, underscore time, host, source, and source type fields, as well as Splunk server, which populates with the server the command was run on by default, and Splunk server groups. You can use Splunk server or the Splunk server groups argument to generate results on a specific server or server groups. We can also leverage the format and data arguments together to create fields with values we can then use to compute aggregate statistics. The format argument tells Splunk whether the inline data should be returned in either CSV or JSON format, while the data argument is used to specify the collection of inline data the makeResults command will convert into events. Both arguments must be used together. JSON data must be provided as a series of JSON objects, all within a single JSON array. MakeResults generates a separate event for each JSON object listed. The keys of the object become fields, and the object values become field values. Each key must be bracketed in escape quotes. The alternative format, CSV, differs mostly in how the inline data is specified, as it consists of a set of lines. The first line contains the schema, or headers, for the CSV table. Then the following line is a comma-separated list of strings, and each string corresponds to a field name. New lines are used to indicate the end of one event and the beginning of another. Now we have a host and location field we can use with subsequent commands. While the command arguments are extremely helpful, there are even more supporting commands like streamstats and eval that are often paired with makeResults for even further customization, giving us the opportunity to leverage makeResults when creating dashboard prototypes, testing, and so much more. Thanks for joining us to learn more about how to use the makeResults command. For getting started guides and product tips, please visit Splunk Lantern. We also suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, and register for courses from Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.